Welcome everybody. This is day 223 of Making Songbringer, and today is going to be kind of a technical programmery type day where I'm still working on getting things, just whittling things off of my list of high priority items to get the alpha version out for next week. One of these things on this list is to combine everything into one scene. So right now the game uses multiple scenes. So for example, if you quit, you go to the main menu. This is a different scene than the actual game. Also, there's what's up, Arcane? Yo, man. There's also the main scene, and then there's also the preview scene, which shows you sort of like what version you're on. This is the preview scene. Tells you you're on the alpha build and all that. So basically, the problem with all that, here's another scene where it's like showing the ship and all that. It's kind of the intro scene. The only problem with having multiple different types of scenes is that controls can kind of get messed up. So I think at least the controls can get messed up. Technically, controls could get messed up if for some reason the input handler doesn't get set up correctly. What's up, Mighty Ness? Ethan, what's up, man? What's up, JFK? Yo, man. Link visits castle's courtyard. Sweet, man. It's the newest one? Oh, this is somebody's, somebody actually made this? Pretty awesome. Right on. What up, PETA? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, so this is, well, like I said, this is going to be kind of a programming day today. We're working on getting that all working with one single scene instead of having multiple scenes. Because I don't even use scenes in Cocoa Studio X anyways. And the problem is that I'm attaching an event listener and then detaching the event listener for each scene. So theoretically, there could be an issue. If the event listener doesn't get detached, there might be two event listeners, and that might be why Mars of Power is getting that bug. So, that's today's goal. Awesome. Okay, so the first thing is to make it so that the game has kind of this power over everything. It has a scene. This is the main scene. There's only gonna be one single scene. Nice. Okay, so the game, let's give it actually a pointer. Actually, yeah, we'll make it a pointer. So that we can choose when we want to destruct it. If this were a single class or even a reference or whatever, I wouldn't have, or yeah, basically if it was just a single class or a plain old class that wasn't a pointer, I wouldn't have control over when it was destructed unless, yeah, I basically just wouldn't have control over where it's destructed. So I want to make sure that I have control over that because it can lead to a crash on exit if you don't do that right. So scene. Cool. So we've got the game scene now, and when we create the game, after we set up the GL view and we do the application did finish launching and all that, and after we do all this stuff too. We're going to create the main scene. So wrong. Pretty sure that's just a nit. Good man. Doing great. Why is that failing? Scene. Yeah, a nit, or there's a nit with size. Something like that. Oh, probably part of it there. Wait, what the heck? Non-static data member defined out of line. Game scene. What? Oh. Yeah. So that needs to be static. Duh. Okay, there, now these, I should fix all those bugs. All right, so yeah, we got access to the scene. We're creating the scene, and then we can create, actually, maybe we'll create the scene. Nah, let's just do it there, yeah, that's fine. On exit funks too. We could even add an exit funk to delete it. There we go. So that'll run on exit. Right on. This one you're talking about, PETA? Cool. All right, so now we need to get it to run. Run the scenes with this scene, and actually everything is just a layer. So we're not skipping menu. Let's see if we can run the very first scene now. Start with that. So we've got text scene, preview scene, color scene, overworld scene. We'll start with just the preview scene. Yeah, post the link, feel free. So let's make this a layer instead of a scene. All right, so yeah, let's just rename all these to preview layer. And preview layer create. I guess we can keep that method for now. I'm probably going to delete this method. And then when we run the preview layer, it's going to be a little bit different. So that's where the whole... So here's where we need to run the main scene, and then we'll be add yes, we'll go game scene. We'll add the current layer. For now, we're just going to add the preview layer. A new one. What's wrong with the build? See layer. Dubs, what's up, man? Are you asking about me or are you asking about Ethan here? What up, Nano? Oh man, crazy. Yeah, let me see if I can run it while I still have all this code in flux. Yeah, so this game's called Songbringer. It's already been funded on Kickstarter. It comes out in January. on Steam for Windows, Mac, and Linux. This is the ship Songbringer here. It's flying by. It's like Zelda 1, but it's procedurally generated. When you create a game, you have 6 letters you can put in to actually create a world. So those your 6 letters determine everything, all the way down to the tile. So I mean, just this, even this little, these rocks here, everything is totally different every time you do a different world. I mean, it still kind of looks the same, it's same art and everything like that, but it arranges everything procedurally so that the whole world is something different each time. So yeah, it's got an overworld, it has dungeons. I think this is the way to one of the dungeons. Where's that? Oh, no, it was over there. Actually, one of the dungeons is over here. It's got to be. I think it's right up here. Oh, maybe not. Oh, this is level 9. Can't get to it yet. Wait, maybe I can. Oh, yeah, I can get to level 9. I got the fire blink. Oh, yeah. So this is it. This is what the game's like. Sorry, I don't really have much more time to show you much more of the game right now. It's a huge game. So I got to keep working. All right, we got somebody to ban already. What's up, ban dude? Are you a real person? Probably not. I'm about to ban you. Just say if you're a real person in the next 30 seconds or so. Thanks, JFK. Okay, so yeah, we're creating a lair, game scene, add child. Probably the best thing to do here is create some method that does all those things easily. But let's see if the game runs now. Now that we made this major shift, it's not a major shift, but it's a quick shift, but it is, I guess, a major structural change in the way the whole game works. But it'll totally be worth it. What? Redefinition of game scene with a different type, Coco City scene versus Coco City scene. Oh, scene pointer. Oh, man. The bugs today, I'm crazy. I'm crazy. Spam. You're a spammer. Delete you. You're the most convincing bot ever. You're such a convincing bot. I love you. I'm never going to ban you. You're my favorite bot. Okay, so if this works, then it'll show the first scene. All right. Cool, and then everything else should break. No, it didn't break. Oh, it's because it's not. Yeah, it'll still work with the current scenes. Yeah, Mr. Destructoid. JFK, nope. No, there's not going to be no DLC. PC Warrior! Limpin's in. Yeah, it's my own font. I drew that in Photoshop. This is, nope, it's not that one. Yeah. So, it wasn't that hard to draw, but it was hard to dial it all in and get the font to be perfectly aligned and everything for each letter. Because it's not fixed width. Each one of these letters has a different width. So dialing all that in was tricky, and that's why you see all these background things and stuff. Oh yeah, and there's the alien font. Yeah, true. So the alien font is something I actually tattooed on my wrists a long time ago, and now it's actually a language in this game. So it's basically just English, but with a different font. That's all it really is. So this, for example, is like letter A, B, C, D. So yeah, there's two fonts in the game. So far, there's gonna be a lot more fonts for other languages too. Like, Japanese will have its own thing. And yeah. So now, okay, the next steps are going to be getting all these other ones to run like layers. I think I want to make a nice convenience method for running a layer. Yeah, might as well. Could even make it an auto. Nice, right on. I can't speak alien either. But the little robot Jib can. So we can understand. Hey, what's up, Toby Peters? Jib just be Jib can just speak alien, but Toby Peters, I thought you were a real person. Maybe you're not. What's with all the spam lately? Okay, so void, we're gonna run a layer. So run, what's it called? Run layer. Run layer is the templates function. There we go, cool. So now we got a method we can use with any class type that's gonna run a layer on the game scene and also release it. So when it's ready to release itself, it gets deleted, destructed. And this is clean, this is nice and clean. So it's not relying on auto release or any other techniques which require garbage collection. So we're doing our own garbage collection in this way, our own memory management. That's gonna be cool. So now we can use this function. What? Okay, all right. Cool. So we're gonna run the layer preview layer. That's all we should need for that. Now we got a much more compact version of that. Huh? Okay, so the next things we're gonna need to do is move these other scenes over to the same type of thing. So these are gonna be layers. I don't know. I don't know, Ray, bro. I don't know. So we got preview layer. Then we're not going to need preview layer create anymore. This is great. So this preview layer create is kind of the same thing as the way CocoStudiX does everything. They do this auto release, which requires them to do memory management with garbage collection type thing. It's basically a dirty method of doing it because you never know when your class is going to get destructed. So it's very Objective C-ish, not very C++-ish. So anyways, yeah, we're ready to do the next one. So let's move all these over to layers. We don't need these create methods anymore. So scene zero is going to be called, we're going to call that one intro layer. All right, and scene zero. Ooh, there's some places where we don't want to do. Okay. This is going to have to be one of these kind of replaces where I do it manually. So yeah, we don't want to erase that. That's cool. This, wait. Probably not that one. That's all good. We want to change all this, but not that. There's two of those. Okay, cool. We replace all those. All right, thanks. Thanks, Ray, bro. Thanks for saying that. Always helps to hear that kind of stuff, especially on days like this where there's so much spam and weird energy going on the Twitch channel. So thanks, man. Appreciate it. Appreciate all y'all that are real people out there. Real people are awesome. What's up, Peen Wally? What's up? Yo, yo. I'm transitioning to, this is going to be mostly a code day today. I'm transitioning to using one single scene. So, Satrick, what's up? Yeah, kind of strange chat day for sure. But yeah, moving on. So what I'm working on today is converting everything to using one single scene because there's an input event listener and stuff like that. No, I haven't. Riot, civil unrest? It could be TwitchCon. Yeah. What's up, no input? Akuma? Yeah, on with the coding. And the chatting with real people. But this is. You got a link to that game, Nano? I'm not finding that game. Wait, maybe this is. There we go. That minus was telling Google not to find that word. Whoa. Cool, I'll have to check this out later on. Check out its video and stuff. What up, Roger? Welcome. Intro layer, cool, we're not gonna need more that anymore. This intro layer create. Ah, yeah. Always trolls. Well, you know, I think I've been trolled the worst in the past already. I really don't feel like I can be trolled any worse than I've already been. So there's that. Texting. Okay, yeah, texting. Convert that one. Yep. Yeah. Oh, that's good. Cool. Don't need text layers create, color scenes create, overworld scenes create. None of those. All right, now color scene. We'll change that one. Yeah, you totally. Yeah. It's not when I first started streaming, it's not that I expected not to be trolled. It's just that I was unaware of how bad trollers could be. So it definitely hit me hard there for a minute. But, you know, it's all cool, I guess. It is, it's just noise. Haters. Haters gotta hate. I guess trolls and haters are not always the same, too. You know? Haters are the ones that really, really suck. Suck to get hit by haters. Nice. Cool, Roger. Oh, you've been expecting it, like you've been waiting for it to come out? It's gonna be out in January. But the alpha version's coming out this week. So I'm working on here, just cleaning up these bugs and stuff. Nice, right on. Thanks, man. That's awesome. Very encouraging. So we don't want to change that one. These. Not that one. Oh man, this one's kind of crazy. We don't want to change that. Oh, we want to do the case sensitive. Case sensitive. This will really help. Hey, what's up, Blood? I'm working on I'm converting everything to running with one scene. So in Cocosuite DX, there's scenes and layers. Scenes, when you transition from one scene to another, it's basically like a whole nother deal, right? So I'm making it so there's only one scene ever, and that it just runs different layers for different, like, you know, modes of the game. Like, so the menu will be its own layer, the game will be its own layer, the preview scene will be one layer. And what that will do is enable it so like when I'm using controllers and stuff like that, it only ever has to hook up one input event handler. And I think that will help with the bug that Marzipower is experiencing. So that's the goal for today. Nice, right on, man. Very cool. I've seen some other really great action RPG sort of Zelda inspired, and some of my favorite games to play are like that. So good for you, dude. I can't wait to see what you create, man. Oh yeah, nice. Yeah, I'll play it again. I just played it a second ago, but yeah, I'll play it again. Mini me, welcome to the stream, man. Yeah, totally. Engine work, exactly. It's code day today. No art, sorry. Not really gonna be making art today. But mini me, here's the game. This game's called Songbringer. It's a Zelda-like game. It's coming out in January for Windows, Mac, and Linux on Steam. But yeah, there's dungeons, there's the overworld. Everything's procedurally generated, so you have you have like six letters you create the world with, and those six letters procedurally generate everything. So you can play a different world every time you play the game, pretty much. There's actually 300 million different world combinations or worlds to be created. So yeah, this is kind of it. You know, it's just like Zelda where you have an inventory, except that you can combine items too. So let's get to a place where we can warp back to the ship. I'll show you where you can combine items and stuff. So yeah, so when you're on your adventure, you know, like in Zelda games, you go and you typically find your items in dungeons where you beat a boss, you get some cool item. Same kind of thing in this game, except you can take some items and combine them together. So for example, you can try combining whatever you want. So I'm gonna try and combine fire with bombs. I'm pretty sure that works. Yeah, so you can combine fire and bombs to create the fire bombs. There's tons of different item combos. So yeah, that's it, basically. Sorry I don't have much time to actually play the whole game today, but I'll be playing it soon. Probably tomorrow or something like that. Right on, man. So, overseen, yeah, all this stuff. Much better. Replace all that. Alright, okay, so yeah, now at the beginning, we can actually run these layers with this new method. So this one will be create an overworld layer, for example. Area, this one's gonna need some work. So I'm going to have to leave that as it is for now. Here we want the preview layer. Here's the intro layer. Hey, what's up, Arctic Raj? Welcome to the stream. Today's kind of a programming engine work day. Working on simplifying the whole game to use a single scene instead of multiple scenes, which is hopefully going to help input so there's no bugs with the input handling and stuff like that. Your daughter wants to eat your computer. Does it look yummy? Is there sugar on it right now? Oh yeah, so we don't need these. And this is going to be a good one to check. Preview layer update. Yeah. Nice. Oh, it does? Nice. That's so funny. That's so funny. Your name is so appropriate to today's stream. That's crazy. No input. Man. Yeah, no, seriously. That's one of the bugs on the list I've been working on. Or have had on the list for a while, is to create one scene because there was this bug where, you know, you've got a controller or whatever, you bound all your keys, you run the game, and all of a sudden you have no input. So that was a bug that Mars of Power noticed, and I'm working on what I hope will be a fix for that. I'm pretty sure it will. Wow, really? Nice, Ray Bro. Good for you, man. That's awesome. So what age is your students then? Are they high school too? So this should work too now. This remove from parent, that should work too. What's up? Oh yeah, so we don't need this. Nor this. Ninth to 12th, cool. Right on. Life Domo has. Sorry, I have never worked with RPG Maker. Yeah. Oh, really? Oh my gosh. Wow. What a legacy. Cool name. Cool name. Is there something you in particular you're wondering about? Maybe there's somebody else here on the stream that that has used RPG Maker. So feel free to, you know, if you have a question or something like that, go ahead and ask it. And maybe somebody can help. I don't know. Okay, so now we made that change. We should be able to run the first scene, and then it should be able to get to the next scene too. Yeah. All right. Cool. And let's give that a fade out as well. What's up, Overcaster? Good evening, good evening. Welcome to the stream. I wonder if this will work. If I fade out. Okay, and then call funk. It's going good, man. Yep, working on some engine stuff today, making it so there's only one scene. Hopefully this will fix an input bug. Nice. Well, in a lot of games, it's different for how Cocos 2DX does it, but and versus other games, right? But in Cocos 2DX land or whatever, using a scene is usually appropriate. That's usually what you want to do. The reason I'm not using scenes is because I don't really need them, and you kind of have to have. See, the way my input works is like it creates an event handler. So there's this input code, right? Which silently, so this input class, and behind the scenes, this input class has an event handler. And this event handler has to be attached to a scene or a layer or whatever. And I will always want to, the goal here for today is basically to be able to create only one input event listener for the whole game. Never has to create two of them. So, yeah. Basically, most games don't need these custom input handler type things. Because, you know, my game uses the controllers and it uses a keyboard or whatever, mostly. So, this is kind of a necessity to have this work the way it does. I don't know, it's kind of a design decision too, so. Man, dude, so many spammers, what's up? Spammers? It's like spam day. The banhammer's out for sure. Yeah, PETA's been banning too. I know, what's up with this? What's up with this, PETA? Yeah, essentially, Pete and Wally, that is exactly how it goes. Except that the director isn't actually a node. So technically, yes, there is the director, and it's kind of the highest order element of everything, but it's not really an actual entity or a node or whatever. There's scenes, and then underneath those are layers, and underneath those are sprites and other stuff. Yeah, JFK, the alpha version is going to be available for Mac and Windows for sure. Possibly Linux if I can get it done. I don't know. I'm not sure if I can get that done in time. Or maybe I'll do Linux afterward. Maybe I'll release the alpha version and then like the next week release it for Linux as well. I don't know. Yes, you can. Blood, of course, man. Normally I only do this for people that, you know, that have been here a long time and I trust them and, you know, so yeah, but yes, I will. Ask and you shall receive. But sorry, I can't do this for everybody. That's all I'm saying. You know what I mean? So don't everybody ask it once, please, please. Which one? I think it's this. Can't see. Op, yeah, there you go. You have been opt. Oh, okay, yeah, these take void, that's why. Okay, let's see if that works. No, it didn't. Oh, wait. It might have actually worked and it just didn't fade. Yeah, it works. Okay, so we need to do a layer. For that. So we'll create a layer to fade with. All right, Pete and Wally. Thanks, man. So let's fade over a second and then remove self, but also call this funk. Actually, oh, there's no need to remove self if we're moving this whole thing. Thanks, Roger. Oops. Okay, we faded that in. Supposed to fade that out. Fade in, fade out. Oh wait, oh it's backwards because we want to create this with zero opacity and fade it in to be opaque. That's much more like a brother, yeah. There we go, cool. Now it fades out. That's all I wanted to see. All right, cool. So the next things we need to be able to, the point of all this is to create only one event listener, right? So let's start doing that. Everywhere there where it creates an event listener, we're gonna not do that. Oops, ignoring case. There. For example, we're listening to input here. So we can now put this into, yeah, right after we create the main scene right here, we can create an event listener and put it on the main game scene. So this is it, man. This is the real juice of all of today, is the goal of doing that, basically creating one event listener. So now we need to go and not create any other event listeners. We'll start with turning that off. I'm commenting this one out first because this is a, I need an area is a very special one. This is the actual game layer or game scene. So that one kind of needs its own finesse. But other than that, these other ones here, we don't need to like listen for input anymore. Taking the controllers is probably also going to be another one we're not going to want to do, but first, remove all these. All right. Yo, what's up, Pedro? K Matsuo, yes, this is C++. All C++. Oh, yeah? I haven't seen that one. I'm working on some technical code programming stuff mostly today. This is this one really important bug on my list for getting the alpha out next week is moving to using only one scene, so there's only one event handler ever. And it's just, it's basically what happens is sometimes people are playing the game, like Marza reported this bug where his controller would work on the main menu and then his controller would not work in the game. And the only thing I can think that would cause that is that possibly there was two event handlers, or there was one event handler that didn't get created, so there were zero event handlers or something. So basically I'm making it so there's only ever one event handler, just simplifying all that. What's up, Coin54? Nice, good for you, man. I highly recommend you learning C++ for game development and for many other applications. It's like driving a stick shift versus driving an automatic shift car. You know, you have more control over things, and it's very fast, it's very portable, and it's been around for so long, and it's still around. That's kind of says a lot right there, you know? That basically you can learn it now, and probably in 20 years, people will still be using it, although it will be better because they keep on revising the draft and making it better and better. That's what's so cool about C++ is all the improvements they've made to it lately. It's actually been a lot of rad improvements. Okay, so we turned off creating the event handler in all those other situations. So We should be able to run it now, and we should be able to get through the first three scenes. Sweet. Only this last one is not working. My keys aren't working or anything. But I think they might have to do. With like an input or not, or the tick system. Nice, good for you. Good for you. That's awesome that you're learning C++ as a home study. It's good that you're learning C at your school, though. I highly recommend starting with C myself. It's a cool language. It'll teach you pretty much the basics of a lot of other languages, and it's also a great start for learning. C++ or Objective C. So the input was not working in the last scene there. Wonder what that is. Hello, what's up, AK Joe Man? So that was the title scene. The title scene. I wonder why. This isn't working at all. Here, let's set a breakpoint here. Figure out what's up with that, because this should be working already. What game engine do I use? I use Cocos 2DX. Stefan, no. Sorry, but that's not really how it works. C++ is not just the visuals. It's not the visuals at all. C++ is a higher level of C. Yeah, exactly. This is a pretty simple way of describing it right here. It's kind of a better version of C with objects and classes. Classes and objects are basically, well, it's object-oriented programming, kind of a big topic to try and summarize, but yeah. Weird, what is up? All of a sudden, my CPU is going crazy. Is that? What's up, Eric Kogan? Why do you think that? Why do you think it's all junk? What? Why do you think they're half-baked solutions? Personally, I think some of, like auto, for example, is a great simplification. The for in loop is also another great simplification. Null pointer is another great, awesome new thing in C++. Without null pointer, we used to use zero and null, which had no type safety. But that templates were already around in C++ 98. And I'm not sure I follow here on how it's basically a problem of code generation. What are you talking about? What do you mean? Well, it's hard to say whether C++ is the best for anything, but you know, because that's kind of an opinion. But I do think it's one of the best languages, one of the best languages for game development because it's fast, it's incredibly fast, and it's also portable. It's one of the most portable languages there is. All right, cool. Right? But why? Right, it is. But what's so great about using templates for code generation is that you don't have to rewrite the same class a million times. Why would you want to do that? Is there a better way of doing templates? In it, like for example, to solve the same problem as templates solve, is there a better way to do that in other languages? What's up, S Ben? No, oh, Ben Olson, what's up, man? Welcome to stream, man. Exactly. There's good in any languages. Okay, what's up with this input component? Not yet, yeah. It's active. Ah, okay. I guess I've never used either of these languages that much, so. I'm listening. Okay, so the input component's there. All right. Nice. Nice, Mighty Nest. Oh, there's an event listener that gets removed somehow. Maybe that's what it is. Yeah. Hey, what's up, Lith? Welcome to the stream, man. Where does that happen? Event listener. Remove event listener. Bet you that's it. Get rid of that one. What's up, Bazarus? What's up, Brandon Dyer? Welcome to the stream, you guys. True, 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 true. There's really no need to remove the event listener ever now anymore. So, what? Oh, only area was the one. What? No wonder. Oh, man. No wonder I had Mars of Power had the bug because it was removing the event listener only once. Really? That's the only place it was being removed? That's crazy. Crazy, man. Yo, Mars of Power, what's up, man? Yes, I have. I'm talking about this, actually, today. This is what I'm working on, having only one scene. So the problem, I think I just found the problem right as you just joined. I realized that there was no remove event listener for this one. So basically there could have been two event handlers. So that bug you were having where you could move your arrows on the main menu and then you couldn't move them in the game. I think I've just fixed it. Or not just fixed it, but I'm on the right track to getting it fixed. So that's what I'm working on. What graphics library? I'm using Kogos 2DX, which essentially uses OpenGL. Whoops, sorry. Why am I after one scene now? So yeah, I've been explaining this a few times, but basically there's I don't even use scenes. I don't even use I don't use Kogos 2DX's scene anyways. So I think it's better to just have one single scene and use layers, because basically what it boils down to is that my input handler, all the input for the game, whether it's controllers or keyboard or whatever, runs through this class called input, which creates its own event listener thing. This event listener could be attached to, I think, any node. It might have to be a scene, I'm not sure. But anyways, the event listener, I only want to create one event listener ever. So just to keep it really simple, right? Don't have to worry about if I create another type of scene or layer or whatever you call it. Like the intro, for example, is a different layer. The main menu is a different layer or scene or whatever. So basically, all of these won't have to worry about creating an event handler, an input event handler. Won't have to worry about updating the input and all this other stuff that basically every scene has to do manually itself. So basically I'm doing all of this stuff only once in the game and basically simplifying stuff. So that's kind of what it boils down to. Do I know how to program an engine? Yes, I do. I prefer not to these days because it's a hell of a lot of work. You know, if you want to go write a game engine and you're a single person like me making a video game, it would take a year to make your own engine that was capable enough to do what I'm imagining for this game. And so it just takes way too long to create your own engine, personally, in my opinion. You know, but there's other phases that you can be in as a programmer or as a game developer. Sometimes you want to create your own engine. Sometimes you learn a lot creating your own engine, or sometimes it is just actually completely beneficial to create your own engine. So it all depends, you know. What's up, Z-Twitch? Oh, you are? Cool, man. Thanks, Marza. That's awesome. Cool, dude. Yeah, I was thinking about that all today. I'm like, So cool. That's so awesome you're doing that, dude. If anybody's wondering what we're talking about, Valtry is this thing I wrote for this game, which is just a data format that reads things in order and is pretty fast and it's very, very simple. So if anybody's interested in that, I've got a lot of stuff up on GitHub, but this is one of them. Valtry is one of the things I share on GitHub. So that's what we're talking about. K Matsuo, theoretically, yes. If you create your own game engine, you could use it for every other game after that. But times change. 10 years goes by, and your game engine has to really, really update itself and go with the times. 20 years goes by, you definitely pretty much, it's almost like you would have to write a brand new engine. So they're not timeless. You create a game engine, you could use it for a few games, but not all of them, I would say. You pretty much, or you could keep it up to date. As long as you wrote it really, really well and you designed everything well, yeah, you could use it with some maintenance and stuff like that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I know, it's kind of weird how they made that. Their event handlers have to be attached to a node or a scene, right? Yeah, there's a lot of parts of Coco City X which are not ideal, but they do fit their paradigm. The paradigm of Coco City X is that you have scenes, right? And so I guess it does fit their paradigm. If you want to have a different scene, maybe one scene can like handle its input in one way, and another scene handles its input in another way. So that does make sense, right? But to this game, I never ever change the way my input works. It always works the same. When did I get mods? There have been mods forever. Forever and ever. Ever before I even started the stream. No, these guys have been mods for a while now, since the Kickstarter project. And Flood has been recently added. Yeah, true, true. Yeah, see? Nice, Boy Pichu. Thanks for sharing your stats here. This is awesome. Wow. Oh, wow. That's crazy. Very cool, man. That sounds like a really dope engine you're working on here. Awesome. I can't wait to see what you create, man. I'm really looking forward to seeing what game you make, man. And I'm also would be interested if you're sharing your engine at some point too. So feel free. And I'm sure there's a lot of other people on here that'd be very stoked by what you do too. Nice. Right on. Right on, Mighty Nest. Yeah, no worries. Give it some time and you'll eventually be able to create your own engine. Yeah. Okay, so I'm pretty sure I got rid of that one call which removed the event handler, which would create an area scene thing. Or 10? Yeah. Nice. Okay, input works there. Input works here. Input stops working here. Damn it. We're still working on this. Yeah, maybe they just weren't part of the stream that day or something. Okay, well, what's going on? I broke it. I broke everything. All right, well, I guess I gotta go back to where input actually gets created and everything and watch the event handler handle events and stuff. Oh, nice. Right on. Nice. Right on, boy Pichu. Cool. Here we go. Let's check out the key presses. Key press, key release. Yeah. Yeah, Roger. I think that was happening though at the end, right? Destroy now. Yeah, check that. Let's check that. Destroy now. Yeah, see this happens in the destructor. So yeah, that's in the right place. But good call. Has too many. No, it has about 36,000 right now. Last I checked, it was around 30,000. So since then, I've added 6,000 lines of code. So yeah, I really got to work on this too. There's certain of my files too have way too much code in them. You know, system, for example, look at that. There's 5,000 lines of code just there. So yeah, I'm trying to simplify things, move things into different files and stuff, and get rid of as much code as possible, make it more data driven. That's the goal. Yeah, my last game was 54,000 lines of code, and that was a bitch. So it was like too much code to maintain. I wish I would have thought and designed better, but I learned a lot from that last game. You know, I learned a lot how to write things more simple. That's when I finally learned how to create entity component systems, which are greatly simplify how much code you have to write, in my opinion. Yeah, I guess we can set that breakpoint and just run it. Just watch the input coming in. Yeah, data driven for sure. Such a good paradigm, right? So there we've got that. Yeah. I mean it's not just writing that many lines of code, it's testing that many lines of code, you know? I mean it's not that hard to go type 1,000 lines, but to maintain and to get that to actually work is just way more than, yeah. Nice. Model view controller. What's up, Cuddlebeam? Also, we're getting two input events for both of these. Is that true? I just pressed the F key. Okay, and what happens now? Now I'm not getting anything. Oh, see, it must have removed the controller, I'm telling you, or the handler, or the listener. Okay, maybe a smarter way to go about this is to set a breakpoint in the where it deletes the listener. Oh my God. So many people to ban today. Dude, I'm not even gonna ask you if you're human. Seriously. What's up? Why has there been three people friggin' three bots in here today so far? What's declarative programming? Yeah, totally. Yes, definitely, definitely, definitely. That's good, dude. That's what I'm saying. Less code is better. Less code is better. Expresses the logic without describing its control flow. Not sure if I understand that. Really? It's just today, man. So crazy. Right? Ah, so you kind of you're describing what a program should do rather than how it should do it. How in the implementation? Right, yeah, that makes sense. Declarative programming, I get it now. Yeah. Mix numbers and letters in a weird way. Oh, his name, yeah, that guy's name. So it must be this, right? Remove event handler. Otherwise, how could it not be getting? Wait, let's also set a breakpoint here when it creates. Nice. It's good to have some paradigms that, you know, that guide your programming. What up, Lighter Thief? Welcome to the stream, man. Sorry, today is kind of more of a code day. Not really making much art today, but yeah. But I'm still getting ready for the alpha release next week. So this is, I'm working on, look at this. I've got my high priority list down to only like 7 or 8 more items or so. Linux isn't really, I guess, I can get this out without getting the Linux build going. So yeah. So anyways, I'm working on this one bug right here where you sometimes wouldn't have your input. So it's going good too. How are you doing, man? How's everything going? What you guys been working on? Yeah, so the alpha release is next week. Hopefully by next Wednesday. That's the goal. And basically all the Kickstarter backers that backed at a certain level are getting it. And also anyone that's pre-ordered at the highest tier will be getting it. Oh yeah. Well, Unity is pretty cool too because they use Entity Component Systems for everything. So you're already kind of writing your games in a good design way, in my opinion. Yeah. Nice, man. Yep, that's why I'm making it for Linux. And like I just said, it's not that I'm not going to do the Linux build for this alpha release. It's that I may release the alpha version and then the week after get the Linux build working for it. So you might have to wait a week for the Linux build to get out for the alpha. Nice. Right on. Well, I would call that data driven myself, but yeah, I would definitely call that data driven. All right, Alex Pita, good night, man. Oh, wow. So that. This thing never got removed, and now it's not even receiving input. Why is that? It might be the way the title scene is created. An art show, sweet. Nice, Lighter Thief, awesome. Art show, cool. Your paintings? Yeah. All right, Kai, see ya. Cool, cool. Whoops. Whoa. Sorry, guys. Sorry. I reset the chat window. Man, sorry. I'm having one of those days. I'm trying to do this like somewhat difficult task here, programming, refactoring all the way scenes work, and my brain is not very with it today. But I think it's the way this title scene. Generate scene, title scene, title scene, duh, okay, title scene isn't a layer, I Man, I should have just been paying more attention. So generate scene as well. Title scene, generate scene, both these should be layers. Nice, right on, you're frantically finishing. Oh man, it's gonna be all right, dude, you got it. Ah, right on, cool. All right, so fixing this whole duh thing, I actually forgot to change the title scene and the generate scene into be layers. Oh, you're the business guy? I'm a business guy too. It can be difficult, man. Teams is a whole other aspect too, to the whole business guy thing. It should be all right. Cool. Yeah, Rudy. Yeah, I do. Oh, is it Woody? Woody, what's up, man? Yeah, my recommendations are this. When you're having trouble remembering stuff, it might be that you're not using it enough. So maybe you should try and do some more tutorials and things that are very very appropriate to what you want to do, right? Make it fun for yourself. So when you're learning C sharp, it might as well be fun, right? So if you want to make a game or you want whatever the heck you want to make, it doesn't have to be a game. Or if it is a game, then pick the type of game you want to make and start doing tutorials on how to make that kind of game, because then you'll learn a lot better. You'll be interested in it. You know, your heart will be into it, so you'll learn better that way. And second piece of advice is learn before you go to sleep. So do it like half an hour or an hour of learning before you go to sleep, and your subconscious mind will work on it all night, and by the time you wake up in the morning, you will have learned some stuff you won't even know. It'll become more subconscious for you, and so that way you remember easier. So hope those two things help there, man. Yeah, totally. So this is the second alpha release, but yeah, this is gonna be more of really an alpha release, and then the last one was really more of a preview release. And then, yeah, the beta version's coming out in 2 months, and then the final version will be January-ish. What's up, PMC? Oh, yeah. Right? Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, I hear you. Cool, cool. Yeah, yeah. All right. Oh, yeah. So there's a bunch of places where I was running like this. running the title layer. This is not what we want to do. This is a new type of thing. So it's game. Run layer. Always learn important stuff before you go drinking. Nice. Yeah. This is great advice. I like that. It's the same kind of thing, right? Yeah. Oh, man. That's so great. Oh, man. Oh, dude. Sucks to hear that, man. Hope you can work it into something you really want to do, man. It's really nice when your heart is into something, you know? When your heart's into something, that's when it gets really good. Yes, it is. It's your birthday. Happy birthday! Is there a birthday thing? Is there like a birthday emote thing I can do? There should be one. Oh, I know, but it's virtually your birthday. How about that? Yeah, right? Yeah, before you sleep, totally. Yeah. I know a little bit about Visual Studio, but I'm sure there's other people on the stream that know a lot more about Visual Studio than I do. So feel free to ask your question, PMC. What's the hardest thing to code for you in this game? Not much, man. This game is pretty easy. The last game I wrote was really hard. It was called Hero Bash, and the hardest thing was real-time multiplayer. Real-time multiplayer is really, really hard to get right. Nice. Yeah, you're virtually older. Oh, that's cool. That's good. Oh, yeah, Indie Game the Movie, for sure. Oh, yeah. See, it doesn't have to take years to create games. It's true. But if it doesn't, the ones that do take years are usually a lot bigger in their scope or whatever. So, yeah, if you create a game that's smaller in its scope, you can still do it excellently with juice and all the fun elements that you would want to put in and stuff. Oh, yeah, I get you. Yeah, the pixels can be pretty tight right here. You can figure it out, though. I would recommend squishing this down as an image first and see how the image looks when it's squished. And then you can kind of get a good feeling for how you would draw it yourself. Pixels? I haven't seen that, but it looks so crazy. Team name not defined? Oh, there's got to be a simple solution for that. Yeah, exactly. Downsample that pic. That's what I was recommending too. Pope said not to use Unity. What are you talking about? don't need that. All right, I think we're virtually good to go. Nice, right on. Cool. Cartridge. Sweet. Oh, cool. That's awesome. Your bots take these cartridges. Sweet, man. This looks cool. Yes. Oh, yeah? Nice. Right on. Well, I mean, it's freaking awesome. It's so awesome of you guys to share your great ideas and stuff. And yeah, and feedback and comments and everything. It's just like really cool to be making a game this way all live and have such direct feedback, you know? Because most, I don't really have that many friends that are gamers. And I especially don't have very many friends that are game developers. So it's really nice to be interacting with you guys because you guys know about game development. You know about games too. So it's like, you're my crew. You're trying to make a person? What's the best team? Huh? Yeah. Totally. Heck, you guys even keep me up on current events. Sometimes I forget to check stuff like current events. Okay, this time we should be able to use the menu. Come on, menu. Yes! Oh! We can use the menu again. Oh, whoops. I did this wrong. I just noticed I did that wrong there. Awesome. Oh, the menu works again. Yay. I just noticed one of the strings is wrong here in where's new game? That's supposed to be a race. Empty is the one that's new game. There we go. When is the office party? What you mean? Yeah, there you go, right? Yeah. All right, so next up on the list is beginning the tick to actually run always, so that there'll always be a tick update working, and so that every scene layer, whatever you call it, doesn't have to create its own tick handler thing. I wonder if the game still works. Yeah, so the game doesn't work right now. The input is not working here because I'm pretty sure... Yeah, it's just not hooked up to the handler and stuff. Oh, for the crew! We do need... You know what? There'll definitely be a virtual party. for every one of these releases, but I do want to actually have like a release party here in the Bay Area. You know, I know that's freaking, it's really hard to like get, you know, to fly across the world and stuff, but there will actually be a real life party if anybody's interested in it. Dude, you should quote this. This is quotable right here. Sometimes I worry that I don't have a life. Then I realize that I'm a gamer and I have many lives. That's so awesome. Yeah. Not only do you have many lives in all the games you play, but you also have many one-ups lives in the games. Dude, there's so, it's so deep. It's so deep and funny and awesome. Seriously, you can put this on your wall. Oh, sorry, Bay. Bay is in Bay Area, San Francisco, Oakland, and all that. Yeah. Songbringer Con. Oh, this is the code? Oh, yeah, I know. So we'll have to live stream part of the actual release party. So, you know, a few hours, we'll just watch me drink and stuff again. At least 99 of them are Mario's. Okay, next step in this programming refactor, doing one scene, is to make it so the tick handler runs itself at the beginning. So the tick is actually going to schedule its update. Tick schedule update. Oh, look at that. So the area is really the only thing that ever schedules this anyways. Nice. Yeah? Oh, man. If I can make the money to actually make that happen, that would probably be rad. Because most of you guys are in Europe, I'm pretty sure. What's a tick? It's the it's every time the game does, yeah, exactly. Every time the it's what runs everything. It's so when the game updates, it's like a game update. So it's a loop, right? So the game loop is something that runs, the loop runs over and over and over and over and over and over and over. Every time the game loop runs once, that single frame or whatever you call it, it's called a tick. And I separate a tick from the animation. So if you check out the way the tick handler works in my game, or the game loop, you could call it, this thing separates out tick methods from animate methods. So for example, it ticks the input system uniformly. So every time it ticks, it always guarantees that k seconds per tick has been run before it ticks. But it animates every single frame. And that's something I learned from doing multiplayer games. So this is pretty important if you ever want to make a multiplayer game. But yeah. Yeah. Oh, you're in LA? Right on. Sweden? Seattle? Oh, cool. Arizona, right. Oh. Anti-Unity? I'm definitely not anti-Unity. I think Unity is awesome. Oh, you're talking about somebody else? Lisbon. Whoa. Calgary? Right on. Yeah, exactly. And the tick is a fixed delta, a fixed time delta between each tick, right? Have you guys seen, so somebody on, I forget who recommended this, but somebody said, watch the Link is Dead video. But the guy that does Link is Dead game theory, he does a funny video on Mario. So if you've ever seen, not funny, but really this is actually kind of deep. Game theory, Mario. Why Mario is mental. This is it. If you guys haven't seen this, but don't watch this if you really if you care. Basically, watch this only if you want the truth about Mario. If you'd rather be blissfully ignorant about the truth about Mario, don't watch this video. Game of Thrones. Why are you saying that? What's up, Cryptic Silver? So the one thing about running the tick every single frame is this is going to be awesome. It's going to run the tick controllers. Oh yeah, we're just going to want to make sure that it resets the tick when it starts the game. Oh yeah, yeah, no worries. Oh no. Right? Here we go. So we're going to schedule the update as well. Game scene. And we don't need to worry about unscheduling really. Yo, Nintendo 10,000? Yeah, dude, it's actually really good videos. There's two videos on him. And you also should watch, yeah, he's got a lot of good theories about games and stuff, but Mario one is probably the most, like, epic, right? Oh. Right? Oh no. Don't work too hard on it, man. Don't worry about it if it's too much. Because your earlier solution is actually pretty cool and is actually nice and simple already, right? It's a very elegant, simple solution. So maybe if it's too much work, just don't worry about it. And I'll commit your one from earlier. Oh sweet, Rudy. Thanks, man. Sorry, the game's kind of broken right now. This is a really technical code day, so I broke the game. And yeah, those screenshots are actually really old. The game looks better now. So, oh no, oh it is. Oh rad. Oh, you should post a link because I'll watch it tonight. If you have a link handy. Oh, it's the midline comment. Oh, okay. When did I start? In November of 2014. So it's been almost a year. Huh. Okay, so tick schedule update. Unscheduled update. We also got to worry about that. Not worry about it, but, you know, make sure that word is in the right place now. Unscheduled update. We don't want to ever unschedule this. Oh, but we do want to reset. This and this, these are kind of things that not really necessary to do now that we're using them always, but I'm gonna put them in comments here to remember that technically this should be there if it's anywhere. Nice. Well, does it need to have the middle? What would be the middle? Tisley J, good question. Does the game look as you imagined from the start? Let me show you exactly what it looked like as I imagined it. I drew this before I ever even started the game. I was creating mock-up images, and I was taking lots of hikes and walks and like just thinking about the design and stuff. Where did I put those? Oh yeah, I think it's in here. Cave squared. There it is. So, you tell me, does the game look like that anymore? That's what I imagined, right? I was imagining it would be like kind of like this is the hero. I worked a lot on the hero to make sure he looked. So he does look exactly the same. The robot looks exactly the same. The girl looks the same, even though she's not in the game yet. I guess this kind of looks like it. I guess I could run the game, but it won't work. But I can at least show you. Or skip. There it is. Nice. Yeah, the porn star stash, right? It's such a good. He's such a good at doing what he does. Cool. Thanks. Thanks, Akuma. I'm gonna watch that later. Yeah, okay, I broke it for real, it looks like. What did I do? What did I do? Let's try it one more time. Oh, in the middle of the document. Oh, okay. Oh man, I broke it. I definitely broke the game. Sorry, guys. How long did the art take? Just that one mock-up image? I mean, well, to draw just this image took about a day. You know, and then I probably spent, a day drawing him and a day drawing her. But I drew these over and over. So this, check it out. I have some really old images where it before I even got to that mock-up image, I had drawn it over and over and over again. So really, I guess to be honest, it actually took about a month for me to get the mock-up images about how I was really imagining. I think it might be in this thing called Sketches. Yeah, it's one of these. This one maybe? Yeah. Look at this. This is what the original heroes look like, right? He was like a stormtrooper, and she was like this tall, weird-looking thing. All right, okay. Yeah, definitely. It's the same kind of game, right? But it's just better graphics. I mean, especially compared to this. Oh yeah. So this is about where I started, right? With my mock-ups. I'm like, it should look about like this. And then I was like, oh, these characters need to be way more distinct, and the background just shouldn't be gray and all that. So it's come a long ways. I know, it's true though. It's so true, right? Yeah. Right? Okay, so let's get the game working again. So I wonder if this even works with this. If I don't do the skip menu, if I can even do the first scene with the tick running and all that. Schedule. Oh, what's up with this? Oh, it's crashing there. Yeah, he does, really? Right, boy, Pichu. See you, man. Oh yeah, these phases haven't been set up. Tick update. It's calling flux tick. Flux tick. Why is. Okay, what's transition phase? Phase none. Transition phases itself. What's phases? Oh, it's a phase pointer 24, and they're all null. Yeah, so this is okay, hopefully that fixes that. I wonder where these get set up though. The phases get set up. Oh yeah, I think they get set up the first time you run a transition, which is It's fine. Okay, cool. All right, we at least got this working. And, yep, the second scene works. Let's see if the third scene with the menu works. Nope. Oh, yeah, I did. Well, it's weird. Like, it definitely did this, like, a pause there or something. Yeah, right? Cool. Nice, nice, man. So if anybody's, you guys should definitely check out Lighter Thieves game he's working on. Wait, it used to be called Llama Quest, but what's it called now? Waves of Time. That's right, Waves of Time. Yeah, you guys should check this game out. This is Lighter Thieves game. Lighter Thief is like an epically good pixel artist. Check, this is all Lighter Thief's art here. Super epic. I love this. Nice color scheme on this sort of title image here. And look at that. See? Look how good his art is. Awesome. Oh, these are the items you've been working on? Sweet. Hey, what's up, Bullseye Pie? You want to draw? You can draw, Azenris. You can do it, man. Yeah. Yeah, cool, man. It's looking, that looks like it's some good work, man. Very nice. Very, I want to call it fluid, but like I'm trying to say is everything was very styled really well. You know what I mean? The aesthetic really flows together very well. Okay, I'm going to run that again because something was off where it was. Okay, that was really weird. I pressed the button 3 times and finally on the 3rd time it worked. Why would it do that? Oh, it's ticking the controllers twice. Oh. Tick controllers. We don't need to do this in multiple places anymore. Like here, no need. I think auto capture screen might even be part of the tick too. Actually, let's just check that later though. Ah. So does this capture? Yeah, it does capture the screen. So we don't need this other reference to it either. Here. Let's actually look for all the places where it auto captured the screen. No longer needed to be multiple places. Yeah. All right, Lith, see you, man. Right? Right, Toik? Hey, what's up, Valware? It's going good, man. It's going really good. I've been working all week on getting these different things done on my high priority list ready for the alpha build. So these are like high priority bugs and stuff that just have to get fixed before this alpha comes out next week. And I'm working on this one high priority one where input sometimes didn't work. I'm simplifying the way it all works. So it's a pretty much code day. Right? Art keeps getting in the way. Yeah, of course. So we don't need that. Simplifying. Man, I love simplifying. So nice when you can just delete code. You don't need it anymore because your design is more simple. All right, let's see if that's working now. Yes, it is. It is very good, right? I mean, that's the high priority list has way been whittled down in the last 3 weeks or 2 weeks or whatever. So there's only a few left here, and then there's a lot of low priority items left. A lot of those. And then there's a lot more awesome ideas, which I'd love to get to as well. But these a lot of these ideas I might have to do after the first release, you know, because the next 4 months is all I have left to get the main part of the game done, and I got to get a lot more enemies done, a lot more bosses done too. So it's gonna be the bulk of my time and story, finishing the story and all that too. So okay, let's see if we got the input now responsive again on this main menu. No. Oh, yeah, not working. Not working. Dang. What did I do wrong? Oh, tick controllers would have nothing to do with the keyboard anyways. So what am I doing? Oh, here it is. Clear release buttons. Because the input system is running now. So, yeah, this has got to be it. I'm kind of getting lucky with all this. Nice. Of course, yes. Yeah, you don't have to ask about posting stuff. Post anytime you want. The only posts that I censor or get off are just posts from spammers and bots and stuff. I love seeing what you guys are working on. This is rad. Look at this, dude. Rad. Rad, dude. Press anything. I love it. What's it say before that? Cool, man. Nice animation. Nice. Good job. Oh, yeah. Yeah, so the input system already does this for any input components that are live. The input system is now being ticked always. So we don't, the tick. Yeah. Yeah, so this is the only place where it was doing it. So we can just get rid of that. And now the input should work again. Oh, yeah? Did I? About the what it said before? What did it say before? Wow. What's this? I don't know. Yeah, it is. It is, especially at first. That's so cool, Peanwally. Oh, the Zelda clone. Yeah, you told me about... You were telling the whole stream about this a while ago, right? Yeah. This is so awesome. Cool, man. Nice caves, nice dungeons. Just looking at this map makes me want to play this game. This looks awesome. So cool, dude. Looking forward to that, man. Looking forward to that. Whoa, what happened there? That was really weird. Hey, good night, Marza. See you, man. Oh, all right. I think what happened there is I let it run beyond this scene. Oh, it's still not working. Damn. Hmm. What's up with this? What's up, Game Vivo? What the heck does this do? It's a bad thing when you look at your code and you go, what's the point of this? Which language do you learn first? Java or Python? Well, I mean, it totally depends on what you want to do, but I would recommend Python myself. It's a little bit easier than Java, just a tiny bit, you know? Yeah. Oh, wow. I didn't know there was a Picardo streaming thing. Are they game engines or libraries? They're technically more of libraries because they're not really the full complement of game engines. For example, SpriteKit doesn't have sound, right? At least it didn't when it first came out. I don't know if they changed it. But yeah, so it's more of a library, I guess. But really the only difference is that game engines technically are kind of more complete in how much they offer you. For example, adding sound or being able to process maps or whatever, you know. Game maps, I mean. Oh, really? Same delay? Interesting. Yeah, Lua is another great one to learn for beginners. Lua and Python. Man, I'm in my time over. I'm over my time already. Man, sorry you guys. This has been such a long stream of just banging my head against the wall here at the code. I broke the game so much that I can't even play it anymore. But this is going to be a good fundamental change. One good thing about what I did today is that it actually got rid of some code. And that's always a good sign when your design gets a little bit more simple. Let's try if we skip the menu if the game works now. I don't think it does. Yeah, dude, I broke it totally today. Well, oh well, I guess that's it for today's stream, so. Why stand when you can sit? Because it's better for my spine. Yeah, so peace, you guys. Just to recap, I'm working on some code bits for releasing the alpha version of Songbringer next week. And tomorrow I'll probably be playing the alpha version a bit on the live stream too. So if you're interested in this game, it's a Zelda-like game, procedurally generated, and I'll be playing it tomorrow's live stream. Probably between 2 and 4 p.m. Pacific time, somewhere around there I'm going to start. So yep, I'll be back tomorrow, and cheers. Thanks to you guys for all the great comments and stuff. So. Thanks, man. Yeah, thank you. So, see you guys.